pests in your home. Now, what if you could get rid of them without hiring an exterminator or spraying chemicals in your house? Okay, I think I would be interested in knowing more about that. Bell & Howell is a name we've known and trusted for decades. And tonight they bring us their ultrasonic set of 8 plug-in pest repellers. Now, this is a birthday price that will expire at end of day today. You're getting 8 of these little repellers. They make no sounds that we can hear as humans, but pests get awfully bothered by what this does. When you plug this in, it drives the pests away from your home in a very humane way. Does it kill them? Repels them. And that's always a good thing. Now, you're going to get 2 of what we call micro pest repellers. And then you're getting 3 with side plugs. I'll turn this way so you can see the side plugs. And 3 regular pest repellers. All of these come together for you at that expiring price of $27.25, which goes away at end of our show tonight at 11:59 p.m. Eastern Time. No batteries to buy, no strips to put up, no glue boards to change out, and no chemicals to spray. This is going to be a very smart way, get it? Smart way to repel pests. Now, here to tell us more about this is our buddy Scott Hind. He's going to tell us why this is effective and why by simply plugging these in, you begin to change that whole pest problem around your home. Let's check in with him now live via Skype. And Scotty, this is something really fantastic for people who want to get rid of the pests but don't want to kill them and spray all those nasty chemicals.
Yeah, you hit the nail on the head, David. 2 things real quick. Of course, welcome back from the Tar Heel State. And second of all, congratulations on the magazine cover. It's
Thank
so
you.
Cool to see that.
Thank
I'm so happy
you so
for
much.
You know that.
Appreciate that.
The key here, David, is all year round, the pests, the little furry guys, the creepy crawly guys are trying to get into our house because for them, it's a safer place to live, safer place to go. There's food, there's everything they need. We don't want them there. But what we don't want to do even more than that is use things like this or nasty spring traps like this or these glue traps, which are really inhumane. All of these are really horrible answers. And more importantly, if those little pests and rodents never get into your house, you never have to worry about getting rid of them. Well, that's what Bell & Howell is doing for you today. You get a set of 8, 4 different types, 2 of each. And what they do is they emit an ultrasonic frequency. Like you said, we can't hear it. Our pets can't hear it, but boy, oh boy, it sounds like nails on a chalkboard to the rodents, to the pests, the critters that we don't want in our home. And when you're getting 8, you can use them, put 1 in every room and really feel confident, David.
And the good news is you get 3 of them that have little plugs on the sides. So if you take up an outlet, you get your outlet back in terms of being able to plug something in there. Now, I need to let you know already we've taken orders for over 300 sets are gone. Now, Scotty, let's go through the pack up. Because there are 8 total pieces here. Some are smaller than others. Some have different features. I'd love for you to just walk us through the set of 8.
I'd be glad to, David. And I think the key here is all of them work the same. Don't look at the size and think they work differently. See how they're flashing there? That's that ultrasonic burst that they let out that the rodents, the pests, the critters don't like, okay? So as you go through, you see the 2 micros. They have the little ones, the round ones there, right? On your left, okay? And then as we come through, then you see the classics, which are just the classic, put them anywhere you want. Then there's 2 with the plug bypass, which we'll show you how I use those in my own home in just a second. And then there's 2 with nightlight, which I really like. Put them in a hallway or put them down in a basement or a workroom or something like that, where when the lights go out, then those little nightlights come on. So it's a dual purpose. But each one of those can be used anywhere, and they all work the same. They just have different features that people have asked for over the years.
Well, we're excited to offer these tonight, and I'll let you know that we've already taken orders for 700 of these are now gone. Now, this is part of our birthday celebration here at QVC. QVC and Scott and I are all turning 35 this year. And if you believe that, I've got a bridge in Brooklyn. I'll be glad to sell you that. But I will tell you this. At the end of our show tonight at 11:59 p.m. Eastern Time, when we hit the stroke of midnight and we show you a new value of the day, this price tag will be over. Every day during birthday month, we're going to be bringing you a series of birthday prices, but they all have expiration dates, and this one expires at the end of our show tonight. Now, it would be easy enough to go out and buy a Brand X set of pest repellers and ask you to trust us. But Scott, this is Bell & Howell. Let's talk about Bell & Howell and remind folks how long they've been around.
well over a century. Bell and Hall was the name in years and years in electronics, in real high-end things like film projectors and lighting, but they've evolved over the years. You've seen them everywhere. You know this name and you know you can trust it. And what I really like about this is they're always thinking, okay? So I want to show you, if you don't mind, David, two places I use it in my own home. First is, if we come back, here we are in my kitchen. Real quick, look around and see if you can see where I have my Bell and Hall plugged in.
I don't see them.
Right up underneath here. Oh. I have the micro one. You can't even see it, right next to my Keurig. Doesn't interfere with anything. Doesn't, you know, emit any loud noises. My pets can't hear it. My dogs can't hear it. None of us can hear it. But boy, oh boy, the rodents, it's like nails on a chalkboard. And then if we're able to go to my second camera, David, that's my personal workbench in my garage. Obviously, a garage is where all of them would enter. And what you're seeing there is the one with the plug bypass. That's another product that you and I present here on TV. It's on QVC. It's a Bissell vacuum. I can still plug that in and recharge it, but still have the Bell & Hall pest repeller. That's why I really love that. You see that little red light flashing, lets you know that it's repelling those things you don't want, those uninvited guests, like right. You said, David.
Hey, let me remind you that the last time we had this on the air was very popular, and actually, since the last day it was on the air, it sold out. But tonight, we've already taken orders for 1,600 sets, and I've got 900 people on the phone lines. And there are a lot of folks that are buying multiple sets. How big an area, Scotty, are these designed to cover? Do we need more than one in the same room? Help us, give us some guidance.
So, a great question. So, David, what they're designed to do is one per average size room. Now, if you have a gigantic great room, I highly recommend putting one on each side of the room.
Okay.
But for your average garage, kitchen, like here where I have a doorway coming into my own kitchen, one is good. I don't have a super big kitchen. You're good to go there. But like I said, they're inconspicuous. What I really love about them, though, is that we don't hear them, our pets don't hear them, but all the uninvited, creepy, crawly, furry, yucky, four-legged, eight-legged people we don't want in here, they can hear them, and it's really annoying, and it sends them away. And then the nice thing is we don't have to use this, which we don't want around our pets, and we certainly don't want to have to use these, which are really inhumane ways and really messy, for lack of a better term, David.
Well,
let's get rid of those and use these, right?
Exactly. We have to live with enough chemicals in our environment that we can't control. Why would we voluntarily spray more, right? Why would we go and get those great big cans of all that nastiness and spray it in our homes when you can simply plug something into the wall? This is a clean solution to a really, really gross problem. And let's be very frank. When you have rodents in your house, you feel violated. You wake up the next morning and there are little holes nibbled in the loaf of bread, right? Or their little droppings on the countertop. Those nasty creatures have been running around on your dishes, on your cups, on your coffee cups, where you go to pour your morning coffee. What? No, thanks. What I'd like to do is get rid of them, but I also don't want to kill them. What I want to do is drive them out of my house to where they never come back. And that's where Bell & Howell comes in. I will tell you, the last time we had this on the air, it was so popular that it sold out after the airing went off the air. And was very popular. Tonight we've taken orders for 2,600 and over 1,000 people on the phone lines. You see all these plug-in pieces, all eight of them? You get everything between my two hands. We'll pull out just a little bit so you can see. You get everything between my two hands. And what Scott said at the start of the presentation, I'll echo. Don't think these little ones work less than the big ones. They're just more inconspicuous. So put those in areas where you want them to be less noticeable. They still do a powerful job in getting rid of the pests in your home. And you've got some that have plugs on the side so that when you take up an outlet with one of these, you get your outlet back. And that really is important. The most important thing to realize here is that there is a better, and I'm sorry to use this analogy because it seems like a pun, but there is a better there's a better mousetrap, right?
Yep,
there's a better mousetrap. And this isn't a mouse trap, it's a mouse repeller. It's a pest repeller. And Scotty, it's a matter of just plugging it in and letting Bell & Howell do the heavy lifting.
They've done all the research. They've figured this out, David. This is something that you and I do not hear. Our pets, our dogs, our cats do not hear this. It will not annoy them. Fine. There's something about the science of it, and I'm not smart enough to understand it, but I do know that the really yucky guys you don't want in here, the furry guys, the eight-legged guys, all that stuff you don't want in your home, this is the way to keep them out. You don't have to exterminate themselves. You don't have to hire somebody. You don't have to spray toxic chemicals or use gross traps that are inhumane ways. This is a really great way to just stop the problem at the door. Literally, have a bunch of guests over this summer that you do want to have and keep the ones out you don't. And, you know, David, this is a situation where the pests and the rodents and, like you said, the mice, they don't go up to a house and say, oh, this is a really nice house. I'm not going in there. I'm going to head on. You know, no, they all 50 states have this problem. So if you're watching this, this is something you could use. And with eight of them, David, you could plug one in every room and really, like you said, go to bed at confidence at night, not waking up and finding droppings or holes. And that's that terrible feeling. Bell and Howell takes that away.
Now, Scotty, we're getting a lot of questions in the chat from folks wanting to know exactly what this is designed to repel. So if you can give us some guidance there.
Sure. Generally speaking, you're talking about rodents, you're talking like mice and rats. You're talking about the eight-legged guys, some spiders, some other pests like that. It's been shown to work on cockroaches, some other things like that. There are, we were not able to test on every single thing out there. So we make the broad generalization of pests, but it's generally speaking, the things you don't want in your own home.
Thank you for that. Perfect. Yep. Now, since we last had this on the air, the last time we had it on the air, it sold out shortly after that presentation because it was so very popular. Tonight, we've taken orders for 4,400, and that's over half the quantity we brought in for the show tonight, and 1,400 people waiting to place an order. Let me encourage you, because price going up at the end of day, to utilize QVC.com or your mobile app as your two fastest and most reliable ways to get in and place your order. Scott, here's another question we're getting in the chat. If I have a two-story home, do I need units upstairs and downstairs?
Absolutely. And that's because as you know, outside right now, David, it is raining. It is what we call in the South a frog strangler. So we couldn't set up the second shot I wanted to. But I actually have these in a crawl space, because we happen to have power there, and an attic outside of my garage, because mice and rodents can actually go up your insulation inside your walls. So it's not like they go up the stairs. They can go inside the walls. So those are actually ideal places to put upstairs, downstairs, and especially if you can, crawl spaces, attics, that's exactly where you want them, because those little pests, they don't want to be around people. They still want to find the food, and your home is where they want to find it. So this is the way to stop it. And it's, again, I love what you said there, because you and I really do think alike on this. You want a humane way for them to turn around at the door. You want them to be like a door-to-door salesman. We're like, nope, no thanks. I'm good. Head on out.
You know what I mean? Like, and I'm out.
I don't want you here. You know? Yep. And then we get on out. And so that's what we're doing here. We're not using the chemicals, the traps. These glue things are horrific. They're awful. And what I really love, David, is as I showed you before, if you look around my kitchen, you can't even see where mine is in my kitchen. It's actually right up under here next to my Keurig. I still have that peace of mind, but it's not some giant distracting thing. It's really inconspicuous. And if we look at my other camera real quick, you can see where I have it in my garage, where really you'd have that problem of the rodents coming in. You still get that plug bypass, so you can charge something up. You don't lose an outlet. It really is nice.
Hey, let me also tell you that this is the kind of thing that you'll want to place on all levels of your home. If you have pets, dogs, cats, no worries, they can't hear it. This is way too high-pitched even for them. This is designed for rodents and pests and creepy crawlies and things that you don't want in your home. This is going to be the kind of thing that is going to get rid of them and repel them away from your home. Doesn't kill them, just sends them on their way. And that really is what we're after, right? Bell and Howell's been in business for over 100 years. It would be easy enough to bring you a Brand X set of these repellers, but this is Bell and Howell. So you can really appreciate the quality and the reputation that backs up an item like this. Now, we brought in for the night nearly 9,000 sets. I have 2,800 sets left and 1,500 people on the phone lines. And guess what? They're buying multiples. They're not waiting with just one set of eight. They're thinking maybe two sets of eight, right? Because they maybe live in a big house and have an upstairs, downstairs, or have an attic or a crawl space or a basement storage area. These are all areas where pests and rodents love to hide. And they're also looking for food. So if you don't want to kill them but want to be rid of them, plug these in. Have you ever woken up in the morning to come in and find little holes eaten out of the side of the loaf of the bread bag? Or seen droppings in your kitchen cabinet when you open it up to get a fresh plate or a mug to have your morning coffee or to serve your morning eggs? It's gross, right? Come on. There is a better way to repel this situation, but I do